Practice set 6.1. We have first question. The question is, if sin theta is equal to 7/25, then find the values of cos theta and tan theta. We have question, we have given value of trigonometric ratio sin theta, that is 7/25, and we have to get the values of cos theta and tan theta. We have to get two trigonometric ratios, that is cos theta and tan theta. Now here we have two options to solve this example. First option, that is using triangle method, that is right angle triangle method, which we learnt in the standard 9. We have first method, that is right angle triangle method, which we use into the 9th standard. And now we have one more option, which we learnt in this 10th standard, using identities. See, if we know the sin theta and if you have to find the cos theta, now we have a trigonometric identity relating these two trigonometric ratios, that is sin theta and cos theta, and that identity is sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. And using that identity, we can get the value of cos theta. Then how to get tan theta? We have one more identity learnt in the standard 9 and 10th also, that is tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. Sin theta is given, cos theta we find by using identity, and the division of these two is nothing but tan theta. So this is the second option. So we will simplify this example by both the methods, using right angle triangle method also and using trigonometric identities also, and remaining examples we will solve. See, the name of the method is not given here in the example, so you can use any method. You can use right angle triangle method or you can use trigonometric identities, but sometimes in the question it is given that find cos theta and tan theta by using trigonometric identities. At that time we have to use trigonometric identities only, we cannot use this right angle triangle method. But here the method is not given, so we are able to use one of the method, since the name of the method is not given. If the name of the method is given there, then we have to use that proper method which is given into the question. So here, first of all, we will consider a right angle triangle, that is right angle triangle PQR. And in this angle, we represent angle R as theta. Since the angle given in the trigonometric ratio in the example, that is theta, we represent one of the acute angle by theta. Suppose the angle is given alpha, we have given sin alpha and find cos alpha, tan alpha. Then we have to represent one of the acute angle as alpha. Suppose we have given sin beta is equal to 7/25, find cos beta and tan beta. Then we have to represent one of the angle by using beta. Since we have theta here, we represent one of the acute angle by theta. Now it is given that, see, sin theta is equal to 7/25 in right triangle PQR. In right triangle PQR, it is given that sin theta is equal to 7/25. That is the given information, and by the definition, see, we can represent it as equation, or that is not necessary to give the name to the equation. So we will write it as it is, sin theta is equal to 7/25, that is the given information, and according to definition we can write sin theta is equal to, see, this is the angle theta and we have to write sin theta. What is the definition of sin theta? Opposite side upon hypotenuse, that is PQ upon PR. We have given sin theta is equal to 7/25, and from the diagram we get sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR, but we cannot use this value as it is. We cannot take PQ is equal to 7 and PR is equal to 25. We have to use common multiple there. We cannot use the numbers in the ratio as it is. But taking the common multiple, you can use like you can write like this: PQ is equal to 7k, PR is equal to 25k. Since we have sin theta is equal to 7 upon 25 and sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR, both the equations have their left sides equal. So you can represent right sides also equal, that is PQ upon PR is equal to 7 upon 25, but we cannot use the value that PQ is equal to 7 and PR is equal to 25. We have to use common multiple there. So here we can write, let common multiple, since we cannot use the numbers in the ratio as it is, we have to get common multiple there. We have to consider common multiple. Let common multiple is equals to k. Now we can represent that PQ is equal to 7k and PR is equal to 25k. Therefore, PQ is equal to 7k and PR is equal to 25. 25 is representing to the PR and the common multiple is k, since PR is equal to 25k. And now we have to get the third side. We know the two sides, PQ and PR. PQ is 7k, PR is 25, and now we have to get this side, that is QR, by using Pythagoras theorem. If we know the two sides of right angle triangle, you can get the third side by using Pythagoras theorem. So here you can write, by using Pythagoras theorem, how you can write the Pythagoras theorem? Pythagoras theorem states that in right angle triangle, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of the remaining two sides. That we can write, PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square. And now put the values which we knows and get the value which we don't know. Here we knows PR, that is 25k. We know PQ, that is 7k. We have to get the value of QR. And if once we know all the three sides of the triangle, you can get any trigonometric ratio. But we have to find only cos theta and tan theta, not all the ratios. One is given and we have to find two ratios, that is cos theta and tan theta. So here we will get the third side. PR is equal to 25k. So we put 25k here, square of it. PQ is 7k, so we put 7k here, square of it, plus QR square as it is. Now square of 25k, that is 625k square. Square of 7k is 49k square, plus QR square as it is. Now transfer this 49k square to the left side, we will get QR square is equal to 625k square minus 49k square. We transfer this 49k square to the left side and it is minus 49k square. Now we have to take subtraction, that is QR square is equal to, we have to take the subtraction of these two. See, we cannot subtract 9 from 5, so we have to borrow 1. Now 15 minus 9 is 6, borrowed 1 we have to give back here. See, we cannot subtract 5 from 2, so again we have to take 1 borrowed. 12 minus 5 is 7. And 6 minus 1 is 5k square as it is, that is 576k square. QR square is equal to 576k square. Now taking square root of both the sides, we get QR is equal to 24k. We get QR is equal to square root of 576 is 24 and square root of k square is k. Now we knows all the three sides of the right angle triangle. The value of PQ is 7k, the value of QR is 24k and the value of PR is 25k. Now we can get any trigonometric ratio, we can get the value of any trigonometric ratio, but we have to find two values only, cos theta and tan theta. So we will first find cos theta. So here we write cos theta is equal to, by the definition, cos theta is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is QR and hypotenuse is PR. So this is QR upon PR. Now put the values there. वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू आर इज 24 के अपॉन वैल्यू ऑफ पी आर इज 25 के, दिस के गेट्स कैंसल एंड वी हैव 24 अपॉन 25, दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस थीटा. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ टेन थीटा. एज वी नो दैट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द टेन थीटा इज अपोजिट साइड अपॉन एडजेसेंट साइड. अपोजिट साइड ऑफ एंगल थीटा इज पी क्यू अपॉन एडजेसेंट साइड ऑफ एंगल थीटा इज क्यू आर, पी क्यू अपॉन क्यू आर. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू पुट द वैल्यूज देयर. पी क्यू इज 7 के, पी क्यू इज 7 के डिवाइडेड बाई क्यू आर इज 24 के. सॉरी वी हैव टू गेट हाइपोटेन्यूज, सॉरी इट इज करेक्ट. अपोजिट साइड अपॉन एडजेसेंट साइड वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू आर इज 24 के. हेयर के ए गेट्स कैंसल एंड वी हैव 7 अपॉन 24, दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ टेन थीटा. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट मेथड विच वी लर्न इन टू द 9th standard. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू यूज द कॉमन मल्टीपल, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. वी कैनॉट यूज द वैल्यूज इन द रेशियो एज इट इज. पी क्यू इज इक्वल टू 7 एंड पी आर इज इक्वल टू 25. यू कैनॉट यूज द वैल्यूज लाइक दैट. सो यू हैव टू टेक कॉमन मल्टीपल देयर. एंड देन वी हैव टू राइट, वी हैव टू गेट द थर्ड साइड एंड देन वी हैव टू राइट द वैल्यूज विच वी हैव टू फाइंड, दैट इज कॉस थीटा एंड टेन थीटा. कॉस थीटा इज 24 अपॉन 25 एंड tan theta is 7 upon 24. So this is the first method. And now we will study the same example by using the another method, or the using trigonometric identities method. We have to use the trigonometric identities to find the given values. See here, we have given sin theta 7 upon 25 and we have to get cos theta and tan theta. So first of all, we'll write the value which we have given, that is sin theta is equal to 7 upon 25. This is the given value. And now we have to find cos theta. So is there any identity relating with sin theta and cos theta? And we have the first and most important identity which we learnt into the 9th standard also, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. And we will use that identity here only. Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, and it is an identity, it is an trigonometric identity. Now we know the sin theta, so put the value of sin theta there and find the value of cos theta. It is too easy. But if you knows the identity, and if you didn't know the identity, then we are unable to use this method. So these students which do not know the identities, they can use the right angle triangle method which we learned into the 9th standard, and those who knows the identities, they can use this method. Using trigonometric identities, we have to find cos theta and tan theta. So we use here trigonometric identity. Now put the values. The value of sin theta is 7 upon 25, square of it, plus cos square theta as it is, it is equal to 1. See, square of 7 upon 25 is 49 upon 625, plus cos square theta as it is equal to 1. Since we have to find the value of cos square theta, we will transfer this fraction 49 upon 625 to the right side. See, this is in the form of addition. 49 upon 625, it is in the form of addition. If we transfer it to the right side, it will be went into the subtraction. So we will get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 49 upon 625. We get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 49 upon 625, and now we have to take the subtraction, that is cos square theta is equal to, see nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there, so we have to take subtraction here, multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is 625 into 1 is 625. Now cross multiplication is to the numerator, 625 into 1, that is 625 minus this minus sign as it is, 1 multiplied by 49, that is 49. Now we have to take subtraction. This cos square theta is equal to 576,
divided by 625. And now taking square root of both the sides, taking square root of both the side, we will get cos theta is equal to 24 upon 25. Cos theta is equal to 24 upon 25. And now we have to get tan theta. So, is there any identity related with tan theta, sin theta and cos theta, or tan theta, cos theta and sin theta? And we have the identity, that is tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. It is an identity. We studied this identity in the 9th standard also and into the 10th standard also. Tan theta is nothing but that is the division of sine and cos, that is sine theta upon cos theta. Now we know the sine theta, we know the cos theta, put the values there and simplify it to get the tan theta. So here we will write the values. Tan theta is equal to value of sine theta is 7 upon 25 divided by value of cos theta, just we find here, that is 24 upon 25. Now you have to simplify this. We have to first write the numerator as it is. This is tan theta is equal to 7 upon 25 as it is, and we have to put multiplication in place of division. In place of division, we have to place the sign of multiplication, and we put it. Since we place the sign of multiplication in place of division, we have to take the multiplicative inverse or the reciprocal of the number which is into the denominator. So, reciprocal of 24 upon 25 is 25 upon 24. Here 25, 25 gets cancelled and we have tan theta is equal to 7 upon 24. Here we get both the values. We get cos theta 24 upon 25 and we get tan theta, that is 7 upon 24. So, this is all about the examples which are based on the trigonometric identities, but you can use right angle triangle method also. So, we will take the next example, second example from practice set 6.1. That is tan theta is equal to 3 upon 4, then find the values of sec theta and cos theta. Here we have given tan theta and we have to find sec theta and cos theta. So, is there a identity related with tan theta and sec theta? We have three main identities in all. First identity is sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Second identity is cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta, and the third identity is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and this is the identity which is related with these two trigonometric ratios, that is tan theta and sec theta, and the identity is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. Using that identity we can find sec theta. And once we get the sec theta, we know that cos theta is the multiplicative inverse of sec theta, that is cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. Using that identity, we can find the value of cos theta also. So, here we will first write the given value as it is, that is tan theta is equal to 3 upon 4, that is the given information. And now we have to find the value of sec theta, since we have to use the trigonometric identity which is related with these two trigonometric ratio, and that identity is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. And now put the values. Since sec square theta as it is, since we have to find it, we didn't know sec theta, so we write sec square theta as it is. This is 1 as it is plus value of tan theta is 3 upon 4, square of it. Now, here we have to simplify this. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus 9 upon 16. Square of 3 is 9 and square of 4 is 16. Now, we have to take the addition of 1 plus 9 upon 16, that is sec square theta is equal to, since nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there, multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is 16 ones are 16, and cross multiplication is to the numerator. 16 into 1 is 16 plus 9 into 1 is 9. So we have sec square theta is equal to 25 upon 16. And now taking square root of both the sides, we have sec theta is equal to 5 upon 4. Square root of 25 is 5 and square root of 16 is 4. So we have sec theta is equal to 5 upon 4. And now we have to get cos theta. And we know the identity. We know the identity. The identity is cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. This is the identity. As we know that cos theta and sec theta are the multiplicative inverse of each other, their product is 1. So we get cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. And now put the values there. Cos theta as it is 1 upon, value of sec theta is just we get here 5 upon 4. So we have to simplify this again. This cos theta is equal to, this 1 remains as it is from the numerator. In place of division, we have to write multiplication. And now reciprocal of this 5 upon 4, it is 4 upon 5. And now simplify this, cos theta is equal to 4 into 1 is 4 divided by 5 as it is. This is the value of cos theta. We get both the values, sec theta and cos theta. Sec theta is 5 upon 4 and cos theta is reciprocal of it, that is 4 upon 5. So we will take next example, third example from the practice set 6.1. Third example from practice set 6.1, and the question is, if cot theta is equal to 40 upon 9, then find the values of cosec theta and sin theta. See, we have given cot theta, so we will write the value of cot theta here. This is cot theta is equal to 40 upon 9. And now we have to get the value of cosec theta. Now you have to check whether there is an identity related with cosec theta and cot theta. And yes, we have it. That is, cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. We have three main identities. First is related with sine and cos. Second is related with cosec and cot. And third is related with sec and tan. So here we have to use the second identity, that is cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. Trigonometric identity related with cot theta and cosec theta. We write the identity here. Cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. And now put the values there, cosec square theta as it is. We have to find the cosec theta, so we will write cosec square theta as it is. 1 plus value of cot theta is 40 upon 9, square of it. Now cosec square theta is equal to 1 as it is plus square of 40, that is 1600. 4 square is 16 and we have 1 0 there, so we have to put 2 zeros. Now square of 9 is 81. Simplify this, cosec square theta is equal to multiplication of denominator to the denominator. Nothing is there in the denominator of 1, means we have 1 there. This is 81 into 1 is 81. Cross multiplication to the numerator, that is 81 into 1 is 81 plus 1600 into 1 is 1600. And now we have cosec square theta is equal to 1681 upon 81. Now taking square root of both the sides, we will get the value of cosec theta is equal to square root of 1681, that is 41, upon square root of 81 is 9. This is the first value which we have to get, that is cosec theta, and cosec theta is equal to 41 upon 9. And now we have to get sin theta.
एवरीवन नोज साइन थीटा इज मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स ऑफ कोसेक थीटा. कोसेक थीटा इज 41/9, सो साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 9/41. जस्ट वी हैव टू टेक द मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ दिस. बट वील राइट आइडेंटिटी रिलेटेड विथ साइन थीटा एंड कोसेक थीटा, दैट इज साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1/कोसेक थीटा. इट इज एन आइडेंटिटी, पुट द वैल्यूज देयर. साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1/41/9. वन एज इट इज साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू दिस वन इज एज इट इज. इन प्लेस ऑफ डिविजन वी हैव टू राइट मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड देन रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ 41/9. इट इज 9/41 सिंस वी हैव साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 9/41. वी गेट बोथ द वैल्यूज देयर, कोसेक थीटा एंड साइन थीटा. वील टेक नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल, एग्जाम्पल नंबर 4. Example number 4 from the practice set 6.1. It is different example as compared to the first three examples. In the first three examples, we have given the value of any one trigonometric ratio. But here we do not have the value of any trigonometric ratio. And till we have to get the values of sec theta, cos theta and sin theta. Since the question is, if 5 sec theta minus 12 cosec theta is equal to 0, find the values of sec theta, cos theta and sin theta. So first we will write the given information as it is, that is 5 into sec theta minus 12 into cosec theta, it is equal to 0. We will first transfer this negative 12 cosec theta, this minus 12 cosec theta to the right side, and we will get 5 into sec theta is equal to 12 into cosec theta. This is 12 into cosec theta. Actually, it is 0 plus 12 cosec theta. But if we add 0 to any number, we get the same number. So directly we write here 12 cosec theta. Now we will transfer this 12 to the left side, and we will transfer this sec theta to the right side. Or you can transfer this cosec theta. Just what we have to do, we have to take trigonometric ratios to the one side of the equation and constants to the another side of the equation. We have to take trigonometric ratios to the one side of the equation and constants to the another side of the equation. So we can get here, see, this sec theta as it is, we have to put this sec theta as it is. We transfer this cosec theta, which is into the multiplication. Nothing is there, means we have sign of multiplication there. And now you have to transfer this cosec theta to the left side, and we get sec theta upon cosec theta. It is equal to this 12 remains as it is. And now we have to transfer this 5 to the right side. It is into the multiplication. So we can transfer it into the division, and we have sec theta upon cosec theta, it is equal to 12/5. This is sec theta upon cosec theta is equal to 12/5. Now see, we have to write 1/cos theta in place of sec theta. We have identity sec theta is equal to 1/cos theta. So we write here 1/cos theta divided by this sign divided by. Now, in place of cosec theta, we can write 1/sin theta. We have these identities. We studied these identities in 10th standard only. It is equal to, this is 12/5 as it is. Now, we have four terms, one below one. So, we will put this 1/cos theta as it is. This is 1/cos theta. Now, in place of division, we will write multiplication. And now we have to write the multiplicative inverse of 1/sin theta, that is sin theta upon 1. It is equal to 12/5 as it is. It is equal to 12/5 as it is. See, once again we write 1/cos theta in place of sec theta. That is an identity. We write 1/sin theta in place of cosec theta.
And then we write 1 upon cos theta as it is. In place of division, we write multiplication, and then multiplicative inverse of 1 upon sin theta, that is sin theta upon 1. Now, sin theta into 1, that is sin theta upon cos theta into 1 is cos theta, it is equal to 12 upon 5. And we know that sin theta upon cos theta is nothing but it is tan theta. So, we have tan theta is equal to 12 upon 5. We have tan theta is equal to 12 upon 5. See, we do not have to find tan theta, but we get it. And now we have to use this value and we have to get these three values. Since I already told you, this is the fourth example from practice set 6.1. First three examples are very easy because we have given at least one value of trigonometric ratio and we have to get the given values or the values which we have to find, that we have to get. And in this example, we do not have single value of trigonometric ratio. No trigonometric value is given here in this example till we have to find the three ratios. But we have given an trigonometric expression, that is 5 sec theta minus 12 cosec theta is equal to 0. And now we have to get the value of trigonometric ratio from this trigonometric expression, and we get it. From the given trigonometric expression, we get the value of tan theta. See, we do not have to find tan theta, but we get it. And now we have to get three values from this. Now we have tan theta is equal to 12 upon 5, and we have to get sec theta, cos theta, and sin theta. So there is an identity related with tan theta and sec theta. There is an identity related with tan theta and sec theta, and now you can use that identity and we will get sec theta from that identity. So, what is the identity? The identity is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. It is an identity, and here we know the tan theta. So, put the value of tan theta here and get the value of sec theta. It is too easy. So, here we will write sec square theta as it is. It is equal to 1 plus value of tan theta is 12 upon 5 and square of it. Now, sec square theta is equal to 1 plus 144 upon 25. Now, we have to take the addition. That is sec square theta is equal to multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is 25, and cross multiplication is to the numerator, that is 169. Sec square theta is equal to 169 upon 25. Now, taking square root of both the sides, we get sec theta is equal to 13 upon 5. Square root of 169 is 13 upon square root of 25 is 5. We get sec theta there. Now, we have to get cos theta. Just we find sec theta and we know that the value of sec theta or the multiplicative inverse of sec theta is cos theta. So, we have identity. So, we will use that identity here. Which identity we have to use? Since we have to find cos theta, we write cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. Cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. And now put the values there. See, 1 upon value of sec theta is 13 upon 5. Now, we can put this one as it is. In place of division, we have to write multiplication, and then multiplicative inverse of 13 upon 5, that is 5 upon 13, and it is equal to 5 upon 13 only. This is the value of cos theta. Cos theta is equal to 5 upon 13. We get cos theta is equal to 5 upon 13, and now we have to get sin theta. We have identity related with cos theta and sin theta. That is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Using that identity, we will get the value of sin theta. So here you can write sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now we know the value of cos theta, so put that value there and we have to calculate sin square theta as it is, plus value of cos theta is 5 by 13, square of it is equal to 1. This sin square theta remains as it is, plus 25 upon 169, it is equal to 1. Now transfer this 25 upon 169 to the right side, we will get sin square theta is equal to 1 minus 25 upon 169. So we have sin square theta is equal to multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is 169, cross multiplication is to the numerator, 169 minus 25. So we have sin square theta is equal to 144 upon 169, and taking square root of both the sides we get sin theta is equal to 12 upon 13. That is the value of sin theta. Here we get all the three values. We get sec theta, sec theta is equal to 13 upon 5. We get cos theta, cos theta is equal to 5 upon 13. And we get sin theta, sin theta is equal to 12 upon 13. So this is important example. Why? Because we do not have given any value of trigonometric ratio, and till we have to find these three values, we have given an trigonometric expression there, and from that expression we have to get any one value of trigonometric ratio, and from this value then we have to get the values which we have to find. So this is all about example number 4. We will take next example, example number 5. Example number 5 from practice set 6.1. The question is, if tan theta is equal to 1, then find the value of sin theta plus cos theta upon cosec theta plus sec theta. We have given the value of one trigonometric ratio, that is tan theta. And now we have to find the value of this trigonometric expression. In this expression we have four trigonometric ratios included. We have sin theta, we have cos theta, we have cosec theta, we have sec theta. Here we have again two options, we have two methods, but we will think about the easiest method. See, we will discuss both the methods. See, the first method, everyone is going to do that. See, tan theta is given 1, so we will find sin theta. We will get first sec theta because we have identity related with sec theta and tan theta. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and from that identity you will get sec theta. Then from the sec theta you can find cos theta. As cos theta is the multiplicative inverse of sec theta, you can get the value of cos theta. Once you find cos theta, then you will find sin theta using the identity sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Separate we have to get all these values, and after getting the value of sin theta you can easily get cosec theta, but that is too lengthy procedure. So how you can solve this by using easiest way? So you have to use trigonometric table here, trigonometric values in terms of particular angles. In that table we have tan 45 is equal to 1. See what is given here. Here we have given tan theta is equal to 1. This is the given information. This is given information, tan theta is equal to 1. And from the trigonometric table what we have tan 45 is equal to 1, that is from the table, that is from the table, tan 45 is equal to 1, that is from the table. And now comparing these two, we have theta is equal to 45. By comparison, by comparison of these two equations. See, we have tan here, tan 1 equal to sine is there. In place of theta we have 45. So by comparison we have theta is equal to 45. And now it becomes too easy. It becomes very easy. Just we have to put 45 in place of theta. So we will directly write that expression here. Sin theta plus cos theta upon cosec theta plus sec theta. And where there is theta, there we have to put 45. So we will write it as sin 45 plus cos 45 upon cosec 45 plus sec 45. And now we have to put all the values there from the table, and all of you know that how to prepare that table for the values of trigonometric ratios for the particular angles. And in that table we have sin 45 is equal to 1 upon root 2 plus cos 45. Value of cos 45 is the same as that of the sin 45, that is 1 upon root 2 divided by cosec 45. See, value of cosec 45 is root 2. Value of cosec 45 is root 2 plus value of sec 45, that is also root 2. Now we have to take the addition of the fractions which are there in the numerator to the numerator, and we have to take the addition of these two irrational numbers into the denominator only. So root 2 plus root 2, you can write it as 2 root 2. Coefficient of this root 2 is 1, and coefficient of this root 2 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 2, and root 2 as it is. Now we have to take the addition of the numbers in the numerator. Same number comes twice. Same number, 1 upon root 2 plus 1 upon root 2. That is 2 times 1 upon root 2. That is 2 times 1 upon root 2. The addition is 2 times 1 upon root 2. Or simply you can write, if you are not getting this part, see, same number comes twice. So we write 2 times 1 upon root 2. And if you are not getting this, see, we have two fractions and both are having same denominator, so root 2 is there in the denominator. And now we have to take the both the fractions having same denominator, that is root 2. So we put root 2 as it is. And now addition of numerator, directly we have to take addition, 1 plus 1 is 2, that is 2 upon root 2. That is same as that 2 times 1 upon root 2. Now here the number which is in the numerator, we will put it as it is, that is 2 upon root 2. In place of division, we will write multiplication, and then multiplicative inverse of this 2 root 2. Nothing is there means 1 is there in the denominator. So we have to write the multiplicative inverse of it, that is 1 upon 2 root 2. Now we have to calculate it again. This is equal to, this 2 2 gets cancelled, 1 is there in the numerator, and root 2 into root 2, that is square root of 4, or you can write it as 2 only. When we multiplied the same number by itself, the product is square of that number. So square of root 2 is 2, and our answer is sin theta plus cos theta upon cosec theta plus sec theta is equal to 1 by 2. So here you can write sin theta plus cos theta upon cosec theta plus sec theta, it is equal to half. This is easiest method to solve this example. We discuss one more method, but that is very lengthy procedure. We have to get
the value of sine theta, cos theta, cosec theta and sec theta separate separate. All these four values. Then we have to put all these four values here. And then we have to use same calculations there also. So here we use the easiest method, that is we have given tan theta equal to 1. And from the trigonometric table we have tan 45 is equal to 1. So after comparison we get theta is equal to 45. And now we put theta is equal to 45 everywhere in the given trigonometric expression. And easily we get the value of sin theta plus cos theta upon cosec theta plus sec theta, and it is equal to half. So this is all about the example number 5. We will take next question in the next video.